And much has changed in the Bozeman area in the past 40 years. And one person has watched much of that change from a very unique perspective.
Yeah, we recently sat down with Darla Joyner, the retiring executive director of Career Transitions, as she looked back at four decades of nonprofit work in the Gallatin Valley. When I first met Darla Joyner, I was a brand new reporter in 1989, and she was the executive director of the Bozeman Chamber of Commerce, which was located in this building that's now a restaurant. When she started with the chamber, just two people in that office, and it was 1978. In 1995, after leaving the chamber as the only woman ever to be executive director, she began working with Career Transitions. It too was small at first, just the way Joyner likes to begin working with an organization.
I'm a Marine, always will be a Marine, and I think that was instilled in me early on through what I went through as a Marine, that you can accomplish what you want to do if you just take it one step at a time. So
one step at a time, Career Transitions acquired new training ideas, an opportunity to get a commercial driver's license. Now an opportunity for a CNA. Getting people back into the workforce as soon as possible has become the mantra for Career Transitions under Joyner's leadership.
So we try to take advantage of opportunities for training that are short term and just in time. I think that's what I see as the most important change for us.
23 years later, she's calling it quits. Kind of.
So retirement's kind of a relative thing with you.
Yeah, I think it's, like I said, I like sleeping in now, not driving so much, but I can't just stay even. I'm not a person to stay stagnant.
With 40 years in nonprofit work in the Gallatin Valley, Darla has seen many changes. Her work in the four decades, the ultimate reward.
We've had people we served 23 years ago come back and say, you know, Career Transitions did this for me. Now I have a daughter, granddaughter, maybe, that needs some help, and I know what you can do. What can we talk about? So I think that's rewarding too.
Travel is the next adventure, but don't think you won't see her around again. 40 years of effort on behalf of people in this valley has given her skills that are still very much in need.
I've loved everything I've done. And it was my husband still telling me, you got to let go. You got to let go. And I said, well, I'm letting go of the operational part, but it's for support and the kinds of things I can do on the outside now, I'm going to continue.
So for that young reporter you helped all those years ago, and the hundreds of people who found their careers in transition that you helped along the way, that is truly welcome news. In Belgrade, Chet Lehman, MTN News. Now get this, while at the chamber as the executive director, Joyner organized five air shows, the yearly College National Finals rodeo events, even a cattle drive down Main Street to celebrate the centennial. It was awesome. Career Transition, by the way, recognizing the work Joyner has done for them for the past 23 years at an event tonight in Belgrade, apparently honoring some of the work she still hopes to do as well.
Wow.
She's going to continue her efforts on veterans as well.
What
as a
woman.
Marine, she's going to continue to do that.
I like how she can admit, like, I'm not good at being stagnant. I have to.
I'm going to lay it right out there. The work that Darla did back in 1989 to help this Greenhorn reporter is part of the reason I'm still here today. So I owe her very much. I just wish her the best.
Absolutely.
Yep.
What a woman.
Absolutely.
And she does deserve to sleep in and get a little travel time
that's
in
for
there.
Sure. That's for
absolutely.
Sure.
Yeah. We do have to take a quick break. Up